Hibernate generates proxies to provide lazy loading for 2-1 associations, and you can use them to improve the performance of some of your write operations. You might have seen the class names of these proxies in your debugger or some log messages. They consist of the name of your entity class and a postfix that depends on your Hibernate version and the bytecode manipulation library that Hibernate uses internally. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen, helping you understand the more advanced features and internal details of Hibernate. Subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. This shows me that I should create more videos like this one, and it helps me reach more people with it. Okay, so in this video, I will show you how to detect if an object is a proxy, a common pitfall when working with a proxy object, how to initialize its attributes, and how to unproxy it to get the underlying entity object. Hibernate generates the proxy class as a subclass of your entity class. Since version 5.3, Hibernate uses ByteBuddy to generate it at runtime. In older versions, Hibernate used JavaSyst or cglib. The generated proxy intercepts all method invocations and checks if the proxied entity object has been initialized. If necessary, Hibernate executes a database query to initialize the entity before it calls the intercepted method on the entity object. If this happens without an active Hibernate session, this causes a lazy initialization exception. Let's take a quick look at the two most common situations in which you're working with a proxy object before I show you how to initialize and unproxy it. By default, the fetch type of all to one associations is eager. That means Hibernate has to fetch the associated entity object when loading an entity. You can change that by setting the fetch attribute of your one-to-one or many-to-one annotation to fetch type lazy. Defining lazy loading for a to-one association introduces a challenge to your persistence provider. It has to find a way to get notified when your business code wants to use the association and fetch it from the database. For all-to-many associations, Hibernate solves this by initializing the attribute with its own collection implementation. But this doesn't work for to-one associations. Your entities aren't required to implement any interface that Hibernate could implement. This leaves Hibernate with two options. It can add some code to the getter method, or it can generate a proxy class that's a subclass of your entity. The first option requires bytecode enhancement. That's a topic for another video, and I'll explain it in more detail in my Hibernate Performance Tuning online training. In this video, we will concentrate on the generated proxy. You can also request a proxy object of an entity by calling the getReference method on the entity manager or Hibernate session. This gets you a proxy object that you can use to initialize a to-one association when persisting a new or updating an existing entity. As you can see in the log output, the call of the getReference method doesn't trigger a database query. Hibernate instantiates a proxy object and only sets the primary key attribute. Hibernate delays the execution of a query until you call a getter or setter method of any non-primary key attribute. Okay, now let's check how to detect a proxy object. Most of the time, a lazy initialization exception will make you aware that you've been working with a proxy object. Hibernate throws it if you don't have an active session and call a getter method on any non-primary key attribute of an uninitialized proxy object. If you're wondering if an object might be a proxy, you can check if it's an instance of Hibernate proxy. That's one of Hibernate's marker interfaces. And if you also want to check if the proxy has been initialized, you can provide it to the static isInitialized method on the Hibernate class. I use both checks in this example on the player-wide attribute, which is a lazily fetched to-one association. Now let's initialize the proxy. The easiest and most commonly used approach to do that is to call a getter or setter method of a non-primary key attribute. Hibernate then checks if the proxied entity object is already initialized. If it isn't, Hibernate executes an SQL statement that fetches the entity before calling your getter or setter method. The player-wide attribute of the chess game entity models a lazily fetched to-one association. As you can see in the log output, Hibernate initialized it with a generated proxy object. When I then call the getFirstName method on that proxy, Hibernate executes an additional SQL statement to initialize the proxy. Instead of calling a getter method, you can also call the static initialize method on the Hibernate class. But if you already know that you will use a lazily fetched association in your business code, I recommend initializing it in the same query that fetched your entity. I explained 5 options to initialize lazily fetched associations in a previous video, which you will find in the description below. After you initialized your proxy, it's still a proxy object. You need to unproxy it to get the underlying entity object. Until Hibernate version 5.2.10, getting the real entity object from your proxy required a little bit of code. First, you had to cast your object to Hibernate proxy to get access to its lazy initializer, which you then use to get the entity object. Since version 5.2.10, the static unproxy method of the Hibernate class provides the same functionality, which makes our job a lot easier. As I explained earlier, Hibernate generates a proxy that's a subclass of your entity class. This can become an issue if your 2-1 association references the superclass of an inheritance hierarchy. In that case, Hibernate generates another subclass of that superclass, and you can't easily cast it to your subclass. Let's take a look at an example. The chess game entity defines a lazily fetched 2-1 association to a chess tournament entity. And the chess Swiss tournament entity is a subclass of the chess tournament entity. When I load a chess game entity that's associated with a chess Swiss tournament, Hibernate initializes the tournament attribute with a proxy object that's a subclass of the chess tournament entity and implements Hibernate proxy. But it's not an instance of chess Swiss tournament. You need to unproxy the tournament to get an object of type chess Swiss tournament. Hibernate uses generated proxy classes to support lazy loading of 2-1 associations, and you can use it to initialize associations to other entities. As soon as you call a getter or setter method of a non-primary key attribute, Hibernate executes an SQL statement to fetch the entity object. The proxy class is a subclass of your entity class and implements the Hibernate proxy interface. This enables you to use the proxy object in almost the same way as using the entity object. The only 2 limitations are, if you want to initialize the proxy object, you need to do that with an active Hibernate session. Otherwise, Hibernate throws a lazy initialization exception. And if you modeled a lazy 2-1 association to the superclass of an inheritance hierarchy, you can cast the proxy object to any of your subclasses. You need to unproxy the object first. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to lots of member-only content, like cheat sheets and ebooks about defining efficient mappings and the best ways to query your data. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!